Ah, the great outdoors. But I don't see any birdhouses.
One of the perks of my job is I get to try out all the cool new tools. So when I was given the Festool table saw, I wanted to get away from the office, take it outside, and make a simple outdoor project. So today we're going to make a birdhouse for some chickadees. The plans for this birdhouse come from a PDF put out by the Ohio Department of Natural Resources, and I'll leave a link to the full PDF in the description. Now, once we set up the saw, which is super easy by the way, and get all our gear on, we're going to rip this board down to 5 inches wide. Now, I'm cheating a little bit, I already surfaced it on 3 sides, but it's a little less than 3 quarters of an inch thick and about 52 inches long. Then we need to cross cut a few pieces at 12 inches, 8.5 inches, and 6 inches, and these are going to be for the back, the front, and the roof of the birdhouse. Then we'll rip the rest of the board down to 4 inches wide, and this will end up being the 2 sides and the bottom. The 2 sides need to be 9.5 inches long, and the bottom's going to be 4 inches square. After the 2 sides are cut, they need an angle on the top that takes them from 9.5 inches in the back to 8.5 inches in the front. And this is where I really fell in love with the saw. All I did was connect the dots and mark a line, and use that to line up with the mark on the table saw that runs in line with the blade. And this was super accurate. After I made the cut, the miter gauge read 14 degrees. So now I'm going to angle the blade at 14 degrees as well and make a bevel cut on the roof so everything lines up nice. And it did line up nice. Since we're outside, this is the only flat surface we have. So I'm going to start to put things away and use it as a little assembly table. Don't tell Festool. So we'll get all of our pieces back out, and I still need to drill some holes for drainage, ventilation, and a 1⅛-inch entrance hole that's 7 inches up from the bottom. So if you were curious what was in that other sustainer, it's the CSC 12-volt drill that I've packed up with all the little things I need, including a 1⅛-inch Forstner bit. So we'll use the T-track in the table saw top and the clamp to help hold it down while we drill, and then it's time for assembly. Since I can't use my trusted Quick and Thick, because we need the waterproofness of the Type on 3, I'll use some CA glue with activator to help kind of hold things in place.
I think I just got wood glue on the table saw.
Definitely don't tell Festool that. Don't worry, it wiped right off the aluminum. Nobody will ever know. And really glad I decided to bring the block plane in case I needed to fine-tune anything rather than take everything off my assembly table. After we get everything glued together and all the squeeze out cleaned up, I mean what squeeze out, we're going to add some screws. And the front only gets screws, no glue, so you can take the front off and clean the birdhouse out later. The saw was great. It was easy to transport, easy to set up, easy to use. Everything was accurate. It was fantastic. Unfortunately, I think we have to send this one back to Festool, but at least I'll always have the birdhouse to remember our time together.
Okay, we're done. All right, now I just gotta wait for some bird friends.
Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe if you want to see more.